If you think your neighbors are noisy, just wait till you get an earful of the serious sounds made in the natural world. We're counting down the top 10 most extreme loudmouths in the animal kingdom to find the noisiest creature on the planet. It's time to pump up the volume when loudmouths are taken to the most extreme. Earth is a planet of extremes. Extreme places. And extreme animals. But some animals are more extreme than others. Join us as we count down to find the most unusual, the most extraordinary, the most extreme. Some people have turned being a loudmouth into an art form. These are the shouting men of Finland. Instead of singing, they scream songs like the Finnish national anthem. The choir was formed in 1987 by a group of young men who confessed they had nothing better to do. But for the loudmouths coming up in the countdown, making a lot of noise is a matter of survival, especially for another group of males living in the swamps of Florida. Alligators are the world's most vocal reptiles. They're number 10 in the countdown thanks to a bellow. An alligator makes far more noise than we can hear. Our ears just can't pick up the ultra-low frequencies produced by a gator, which is why scientists analyze the calls with special recording equipment. Deep bass notes called infrasound are generated within the alligator's body. We can see these infrasonic calls not only on the computer screen, but in the dancing water on the alligator's back. While high-frequency calls tend to bounce back off objects, infrasound will roll around things in its path. That's why, for alligators, it's such a useful means of long-distance underwater communication. Recently, it's been discovered that some humans have also been using infrasonic calls to communicate, not underwater, but in church. Organ players have been adding infrasound to the mix for more than 500 years. Organs work by blowing air through pipes of differing length. The longer the pipe, the deeper the note. Many churches and cathedrals have organ pipes that are so long, they produce frequencies too low for the human ear to detect. And while you may not be able to hear the notes, it seems that you really can feel the beat. Because of its low frequency, infrasound can penetrate objects, including the human body. We may not be able to hear the infrasound, but experiments have shown that people exposed to ultra-low frequencies report feelings of extreme sorrow or anxiety. It's also been found to cause changes in blood pressure and respiratory rate. And at its worst, result in nausea, vomiting, and bowel spasms. Researchers have suggested that the organ's infrasound may be responsible for enhancing the congregation's feelings of intense spirituality. Certainly, an alligator's infrasonic call can enhance people's feelings of intense fear. However, these loudmouths bellow not to scare humans, but to attract females and scare off males. Maintaining their territory in the swamp means that any infrasonic rumble in the neighborhood has to be answered with a call of their own. The only trouble is that there are many sources of infrasound, including combustion engines. Alligators at Cape Canaveral face an even bigger challenge.
Lift off. 30 minutes.
That's why the deafening roar of the space shuttle is usually greeted with a chorus of infrasonic rumbles. An alligator can't compete with one of the loudest noises on the planet, but there are animals that can, and we'll be meeting them later in the countdown. High on a hill was a lonely goat herder who came up with a novel way of communicating.
There's no mistaking that sound, yodeling. And there's no mistaking the place, the Swiss Alps, the one place in the world where they really know how to yodel.
In Europe, yodeling was first used as a means of communication between mountain peaks. It's also a good way to meet a mate, which is why our next contender uses a very similar technique. New Zealand may be a long way from the Swiss Alps, but high on a hill sits another lonely male. He's waiting for nightfall so that he can sing a very loud love song. These deep, booming calls can travel more than 5 kilometers. They're the song of the loudest bird on the planet, the kakapo. During the breeding season, this large flightless parrot moves to a prominent hilltop with low-growing vegetation. He clears an area to act as an amphitheater and then inflates an air sac within his chest. The resonating boom announces to any females in the area that he's ready to mate. Every night for 4 months, he pumps out up to 10,000 of these booming calls, and several thousand whistles as well. But there's another large green flightless creature that uses a different technique to generate a lot of noise. In Philadelphia, people love the Philly Fanatic. And this is no ordinary team mascot, as the Fanatic's manager, Tom Burgoyne, explains.
The Philly Fanatic is actually very much like the kakapo. He's green, he's fat, he's flightless, but there is one difference. Whereas the kakapo is one of the loudest species on the planet, the fanatic doesn't say a word, doesn't make a sound. It creates a lot of excitement, a lot of noise. Fans go crazy when they see him, but the fanatic is mute.
As the official mascot of the Philadelphia baseball team, the fanatic's an expert at creating noise. Century. The Fanatic's been entertaining fans in Philadelphia and across the nation. Recently, he became part of the National Baseball Hall of Fame. Luckily, the Philly Fanatic only tries to entertain humans and not kakapo females. Or in the forests of New Zealand, his big green belly would go unnoticed unless he was producing the loudest bird song in the world. However, the kakapo's 5-kilometer call is no match for our next contender. It's a loudmouth with a cry that's so loud, it travels 3 times farther. Our first 2 contenders really knew how to make themselves heard, but there are plenty of loudmouths still to come. Could some of them be howling mad? And what have these guys got to scream about? To find the next contender in our countdown of extreme loudmouths, take a trip into the frozen heart of a Minnesota wilderness. You'll need some good boots, a thick jacket, and a very loud mouth.
Ooh. Ooh.
These people have paid for a chance to communicate with wolves. In good conditions, howling wolves can be heard 16 kilometers away. They need to be real loudmouths, because their territory can extend over 260 square kilometers. Wolves are number 8 in the countdown because their howls are very loud and very complex. Each wolf in the pack can identify the others based on call alone. Since the pack is the center of a wolf's universe, howling is the glue that keeps the individuals together. Researchers have discovered that the loudest howls are produced by many wolves in chorus. The wavering calls and rapid changes in pitch make it difficult to distinguish the number of individuals calling. Then, as the sound travels through the wilderness, it's further distorted as it bounces around trees, ridges, and valleys. This can make it hard to work out just how big the pack is, which is a nice trick if you're vastly outnumbered. Strangely enough, this phenomenon can be linked to the story of a man who died in the Sahara Desert. Back in 1924, author P.C. Wren wrote a novel about a young Englishman who joined the French Foreign Legion. Unfortunately, his small troop became trapped in a fort by a vastly superior force of Tuareg fighters. To disguise their weakness, the defenders propped up dead soldiers in the parapets and made so much noise that the attackers thought there was a full garrison defending the fort. The story was called Beaujeste. By mixing up their chorus of howls, wolves use the Bo-Jest effect to confuse rival packs. By sounding like a much bigger pack, these loudmouths may be able to scare off their enemies. It's a clever trick, but in a forest on the other side of the world, there's another animal that guards its territory by making an even louder noise. So far, we've heard a haunting howl and a booming bass. But still to come is another noise that can really get you in trouble with your neighbors. And later, it's time to call in the cavalry when a jumbo-sized loudmouth lets rip with a massive blast. In South and Central America, the next contender in our countdown of extreme loudmouths is very protective about the fruit trees in its territory. In fact, it has the noisiest security system in the forest. It's easy to see how the howler monkey got its name. These loudmouths howl to mark their territory and to intimidate rival troops. Even listening from down at ground level would be like having your ear next to a blender at full speed. The secret to the howler monkey's vocal volume is in its swollen throat. Unlike humans, the monkey has a special bony pouch extending off the voice box that acts as a resonating chamber, amplifying the howls. These chambers are bigger in the males than the females, so the male calls are much louder and deeper. But howler monkeys aren't the only loudmouths that can upset their neighbors. More than a third of adult Americans snore. It can be a real problem, especially when some people can generate snores as loud as a howler monkey. The trouble starts during deep sleep, when the muscles in the roof of the mouth, tongue, and throat relax. If they get too floppy, they strike each other and vibrate during breathing. The more narrow the airway, the more forceful the airflow becomes. Tissue vibration increases, and the snoring grows louder. While these loudmouths are definitely not welcome in the bedroom, they'd be right at home in the forests of South America. However, not even the howler monkey's throat pouch can compete with our next contender. It amplifies its calls in a resonating chamber that's 3 meters long. In the heat of battle, there was a time when the bugle was the perfect way of signaling that it was time to attack. And our next contender also uses a loud trumpet blast to signal its charge. Stampeding into number 6 in the countdown is the elephant. Perhaps it's not surprising that the world's biggest land animal also makes a lot of noise. Elephants have more than 25 different calls. The sound comes from air blasted out of their enormous lungs and channeled through the trunk, a 3-meter-long resonating chamber. These calls are so loud they could drown out a jackhammer. But elephants can also make calls that travel 10 times farther. Scientists recently discovered that, just like alligators, elephants produce noise in such low frequency, we need recording equipment to hear them. The secret language of elephants is revealed when we play those noises back at higher speed. These low-frequency calls are elephant infrasound. They produce these rumbles inside a cavity at the base of the tongue. The low wavelengths produced travel greater distances because they're less easily scattered by obstacles on the way to neighboring herds. This way, an individual can broadcast a message over an area of 280 square kilometers. But that's nothing compared to some other gigantic producers of infrasound. When volcanoes erupt, they move large volumes of air, which in turn generates ultra-low frequency sound waves that can travel halfway around the world. In fact, scientists are only just discovering that all kinds of natural disasters produce infrasound, including the one that hit Thailand on the day after Christmas 2004. The morning started out like any other. Many tourists went shopping. Others chose to see the sights with a relaxing elephant ride. None of them knew that on that day, one of the safest places to be was on the back of an elephant. Early that morning, the islands were bathed in infrasound. And the first to know were the elephants. The elephants heard something big approaching from out at sea. According to eyewitnesses, ignoring the orders of their owners, they turned around and headed inland, taking their tourists with them. A few moments later, the people realized why.
Look at the waves coming! Clear out, people! Get in the room.
Okay, girls. A tsunami is a generator of infrasound because the up and down movements of the waves act as a giant loudspeaker, pushing the air at infrasonic frequencies which, luckily for some tourists, can be detected by elephants. However, we have no trouble hearing the elephant's deafening trumpet or the screech of our next contender. It's a loudmouth that's so noisy, it has to use built-in earmuffs so it doesn't go deaf. If you thought trumpeting elephants and howling monkeys were loud, then break out the earplugs, because crawling up next is a bug so noisy that it terrorizes entire cities. And later, why would anyone want a car stereo that's so loud it could kill? Be a giant, but it really does terrorize cities. Crawling in to number 5 in the countdown is the loudest insect in the world, the cicada. This little bug can be as loud as a chainsaw at full throttle. They make this exceptional noise with a pair of ribbed membranes at the base of the abdomen. by contracting and releasing internal muscles the membrane flexes. It's a bit like pushing a paint tin lid. When the membrane pops inward, it produces a pulse of sound. In quick succession, the effect can be deafening. Smaller species sing in such a high pitch that it can't be heard by humans, but may cause dogs to howl in pain. The noise is actually a mating call belted out by males. Each species has its own distinctive song that only attracts females of its own kind. But then, cicadas aren't the only residents in big cities that generate a lot of noise. Welcome to the streets of New York, one of the loudest cities in the world. One man who assesses these noise levels is Martin Schiff, an acoustical consultant for Cerami Associates.
The noise that you hear on the street in a place like New York, it can really be dissected into a dozen different sources. You have cars and trucks, they have engines and horns, and there's tire noise. Buildings have air conditioning systems, they have fans and blowers, you've got people talking all around you. An interesting thing in a dense city like New York is that when you have tall buildings that are close to the street, the sound tends to reverberate in the street, it tends to dwell. Times Square is probably the loudest place in New York City on the street level.
Many recordings here show levels in excess of 85 decibels. Prolonged exposure to this volume of sound can cause permanent damage to the tiny hair cells in the inner ear, leading to hearing loss. Perhaps the citizens of New York could learn something from the cicada. These loudmouths must protect themselves from the volume of their own singing. That's why they retract a tendon that creases their eardrum and prevents damage from these intense vibrations. However, wearing internal earmuffs would be a real problem for our next contender. It uses sound to see in the dark. The night can be full of terrifying noises. Yet one of the scariest animals of them all is a loudmouth that we can't hear. A bat can scream its head off, and yet we'll never know it's there. Bats are number 4 in the countdown because they can generate incredibly loud noises that are too high-pitched for us to hear. This is ultrasound, and bats use it like sonar to see in the dark. They send out high-pitched screeches from their mouth and listen for the echo. Bats use ultrasound because it bends less and reflects a more accurate picture than those frequencies we can hear. They use their super high-pitched screams both to navigate and hunt. Bats on the prowl emit about 10 calls a second, but this rate increases to 100 or more when it closes in for the kill. That's how bats can determine the size, location, and movement of any insect at a distance, no matter how dark it is. But bats aren't the only ones to use sound to see. Ivan Pivak is blind, yet he has no trouble navigating the streets of Auckland, New Zealand, thanks to some technology borrowed from the bat. Ivan wears a head unit that sends out silent ultrasonic waves. Just like a bat, the echo bounces back, providing information about the distance and density of the objects he encounters. The unit was developed by the director of Bat Technologies, Leslie Kay. After many years of studying bat sonar, Leslie worked out a way to convert the silent ultrasonic signal into a sound we can hear. He calls it acoustic flow. By listening to the stream of sound, an experienced user can navigate with remarkable precision.
I compare myself to a bat because that's exactly what I'm doing, using bat sonar to navigate within my environment. The bat knows the difference between a piece of food and something it can't eat. Likewise for me too, when I'm traveling in my environment, I know the difference in the surface between, say, a human and a telegraph pole.
Someday, Ivan and Leslie say that users will be able to distinguish between different faces. But it'll take some time before our technology can match these loudmouths. Bat sonar is so precise, it can distinguish between objects only separated by twice the width of a human hair. So far, we've heard bats in the dark and bugs in the park. But still to come, we'll meet an animal that talks really loud by blowing bubbles out its bottom. And we'll discover why some people blow up their car using nothing but noise. To find the next contender in our countdown of extreme loudmouths, we travel to a school where you can hardly hear yourself think.
Good morning, dear children. Good morning to you. Good morning, dear children. Good morning to you.
One study showed that many classrooms in the United States are so noisy, only 75% of what the teacher says can be heard. So imagine trying to communicate to a school of 4 billion individuals. No wonder herring have found an unusual way of being heard, because they live in the largest schools in the world. Congregations of herring can stretch for 4 cubic kilometers. They're one of the densest concentrations of animals on the planet. No one knew that herring were loudmouths until a scientific study in 2003 discovered that when herring released a stream of bubbles, they produced a noise. Only, the bubbles weren't coming from the fish's mouths. Herring were making a noise called a fast repetitive tick by emitting gas from their bottoms. Fast repetitive ticks, or FRTs, last between 1 and 7 seconds and are produced at such a low frequency that scientists needed specialized equipment to hear them. Each FRT may be small, but they're extremely loud. The herring is number 3 in the countdown because the noise produced by an FRT is the equivalent of a jet at takeoff. Scientists think the most likely use of FRTs is for social contact to prevent the school scattering. But perhaps it's not surprising that others have suggested the loud emissions could be used to scare predators away. Should a human make an FRT in public, the result can be embarrassing. But then, some noises can even make you sick. Anyone who has worked in an open-plan office knows just how annoying noises can be.
Ricky, this is Jane. I'm ceramic. I need the electrician here today.
It's no wonder that people call in acoustical consultant Martin Schiff from Cerami Associates in New York. He has three ways to find out just how annoying your office really is.
One of the tests we can do is a sound transmission test. We use this device to generate what's called pink noise, which sounds a lot like static. We amplify it through this loudspeaker and then use a sound level meter to measure the level of noise inside the room. This is called a tapping machine. We use it to test how much noise goes through the floor from people walking. We can pop a balloon and use the sound level meter to measure how long it takes the sound to decay.
It's Martin's job to provide advice on how to reduce the noise levels in a building, which is important because noisy workplaces have been shown to increase stress that can lead to medical and psychological problems. So, spare a thought for the poor old heron. How would you like to live surrounded by 1 billion neighbors that are always FRTing? Dive into the waters of the Pacific Ocean, and you may hear the songs of the animals at number 2 in the countdown. Of all the whales, the humpback is the most vocal. Its songs last anywhere from a few minutes to more than half an hour and can be heard up to 160 kilometers away. But another whale is such a loudmouth that it can produce a noise to rival a rocket. One of the world's biggest sounds comes from the world's largest animal, the blue whale. Unlike humans, whales don't have vocal cords. Instead, they make noise by moving air from the larynx into their nasal sacs. The resulting honk when a blue whale blows its nose is so loud, it can be heard by a whale on the far side of the Atlantic Ocean. It's thought that their infrasonic calls bounce between layers of water of different temperatures. This serves to funnel their song right across the Atlantic. To find the human equivalents of the blue whale, you need to travel to Scarborough, England. This is a screaming competition. The rules are simple. Just scream as loud as you can.
Suey!
While most of us would be lucky to break 110 decibels, the loudest scream in the world reached 129. That's louder than an ambulance siren. Listening to the world's best human screamers definitely crosses the pain threshold. But there's another whale that can be so loud, it's lethal. The sperm whale hunts using sound. The action takes place in the darkest depths of the ocean, so scientists can only guess at what happens. When the whale dives, it navigates like a bat, firing out pulses of sound and listening to the echoes. The reflected sound gives them a picture of their surroundings, and it also locates their prey, a giant squid. Scientists think the sperm whale can focus its sonar into a tight beam. The result is a sonic cannon, firing pulses of sound as loud as a rocket launch. That's more than enough to stun even a giant squid. But it's still not enough to make the sperm whale the most extreme loudmouth in the countdown. We've seen the nine contenders. They're the best of the best. Only one animal is a more extreme screaming machine. The most extreme loudmouth in the countdown may not be an opera singer, but it can break glass using nothing but sound. Every material has a natural frequency at which it vibrates.
Close.
If you impart enough energy to the glass at its resonant frequency, you can cause the glass to shatter. However, our next contender doesn't smash a champagne flute, but an aquarium. The loudest animal in the countdown is the pistol shrimp. Found in tropical reefs around the world, this shrimp gets its name because it uses that large claw to fire a bullet of sound. It's a sonic boom so loud it can break glass or the protective armor of other shrimps. The concussion is strong enough to kill shrimp and fish 2 meters away. The pistol shrimp's claw looks suitably lethal, but scientists have discovered that it wasn't directly responsible for the terrible noise. When they took a closer look at the claw, they found that the sound was not generated when the pincers slammed into each other. Instead, when the shrimp closes its claw, it shoots out a jet of water that moves so fast it creates an air bubble in the sea. When the bubble implodes, it creates a massive shockwave. The noise of this tiny explosion is thought to be even louder than sounds generated by a mighty whale. When researchers examined the explosion in the dark, they discovered that the collapsing bubble also emits a tiny flash of light. It only lasts for a few trillionths of a second, but in that time, the temperature inside the bubble must momentarily climb above 4,700 degrees Celsius. The flash from the collapsing bubble is too small for us to see with the naked eye. But the associated sonic boom is more than enough to kill shrimp and break glass. There is one sport that also breaks glass. drag racers really are ear-splitting loud and proud. These engines blast out more than 130 decibels. But there's another form of drag racing that's loud, much louder. Welcome to the wonderful world of decibel drag racing.
It's very similar to like a streetcar drag racing, except you don't take off.
Contestants race not with engines, but some very high-tech car stereos. The aim is to find out who can make the most noise, even if it means generating sounds that would instantly perforate your eardrum. Simply choose your favorite tone and pump up the volume. In the extreme class, some stereos can blast out more than 170 decibels. But that does require some serious modifications. After all, ordinary cars are not designed to cope with the noise equivalent of a jet engine at takeoff, which is why some competitors make sure that the vibrations don't shake the car to pieces by bolting the doors shut with threaded 25mm steel rods. And they replace the windows with plexiglass up to 2 centimeters thick. They even reinforce the doors by filling them with concrete. And all this to survive a decibel drag race that will last less than 5 seconds. In the extreme class, the volume of noise generated by the speakers requires so much power that after only a few seconds, the system burns out. While decibel drag racing is an expensive hobby, the Pistol Shrimp Sonic Blast is low-tech and low-maintenance. With nothing more than a flick of its claw, a shrimp can generate noises in excess of 200 decibels. So, it's no wonder that when it comes to making a lot of noise, the Pistol Shrimp really is the most extreme.